Hello, my friends. Hello, Rushers fans of the Broadway. This is Celine Dion, and you are watching Stage Rush TV.
Hello, Rushers! This is Bernadette Peters, and you are watching Stage Rush TV.
Mm-hmm. Hello, Rushers! This is Kristin Chenoweth, and you are watching Stage Rush TV. Bye!
Hey, Rushers! This is Christina Bianco from NEWSical, and you are watching Stage Rush TV.
What's going on, Rushers? Welcome back to Stage Rush TV. So since I'm always a sucker for a good Celine Dion performance, I was completely taken by Christina Bianco's performance at NEWSical off Broadway. It's a show where they basically take stories ripped from the pop culture headlines and they totally tear them apart SNL style. And Christina Bianco is one of the standout performers in this show. The gig that brought her to stardom was actually the very famous and loved Forbidden Broadway. She was actually in its final incarnation just a handful of years ago. And now she's doing NEWSical and she is so funny. And I really think that she has become one of Off-Broadway's most valuable comedic actresses. And so I sat down with her and we had a really fascinating talk about her incredible voice and why she never wanted to pursue a recording career, because Christina can sing just as good as Lady Gaga, Celine Dion, Christina Aguilera. Why do we know this? Because she sings like them, just with their exact voices in the show. She impersonates them. And it's funny when she does it, but the thing is, you close your eyes and you think you're listening to them. It's incredible. So she talks about why she doesn't want to go for a recording career. And she tells a great story about her going on America's Got Talent this past season and getting yelled at by Sharon Osbourne. And she even played Dora the Explorer and met her husband while playing that role, which is really great. So check out her story on Stage Rush. But Christina has also mastered the art of being a full-time working actor. And even though she hasn't gotten to Broadway yet, she's constantly doing cabaret shows and voiceover gigs, which is so important if you want to continue to work, even if you're not going to be a marquee star at this point. So anyway, she has some great stories about voiceover work and some of the strange jobs that she's been asked to do with that. So check that out.
Yeah, I have an ongoing commercial that I'm a voice for, and it's been great to have that.
Is it a commercial that we would see on TV?
Yeah. I don't know if you're able to pick my voice out, but it's for strawberry shortcake toy products.
Okay. Awesome.
So if you hear a voice that sounds maybe like a cross between a kid voice and the Arnold Schwarzenegger number mixed with a little bit of Kristin Chenoweth, it's probably me.
Arnold Schwarzenegger, Kristin Chenoweth, all in one.
Know.
That's amazing.
I had to sing. It was strange in how it came about. Somebody called me and said, can you sing America the Beautiful over the phone to somebody in China? That was my audition. And I had to sing it really slowly and with no vibrato at all, really, really sweet, with, I think they wanted, with a dreamlike quality. And so that was probably the strangest thing I had to do, hold the phone up. Okay, can you do it a little bit thinner? Okay. It was so funny just doing it all over the phone and wondering if that was going to get me the job and how it sounded between my home and China.
Well, thank you so much to Christina Bianco for joining us this week. Please check out her full story on Stage Rush. So moving on to some Broadway grosses, Billy Elliot sold 78% of its tickets, and these are the numbers that reflect the week that Billy Elliot announced that it would actually be closing in January, just after the new year. Big surprise to me, even though we've been watching its numbers fall over since the summer, but still, this is such a show that came with such large fanfare and was so successful for so long, not only at the box office, but critically, and winning all those Tony Awards, including Best Musical. Really thought it would have a longer run. Now, a run of 3 years is not shabby at all, but I think everyone just expected it to be more like a run like Wicked, or something along those lines. So kind of surprising, so Billie Eilish will be leaving us come 2012. How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying is still selling very strong, but for a show that was selling out completely for so long, it now sold 85% of its tickets this past week, which I think is kind of strange for a show that stars Daniel Radcliffe. Man and Boy, which is currently in previews, ending this Sunday, it sold 69% of its tickets, which is kind of weak. Maybe they're waiting for the reviews to come out, hoping that they'll be very good. And Priscilla, Queen of the Desert, who we have been watching struggle for so long, managed to climb back up a bit, selling 77% of its tickets. So maybe some intense marketing and PR work, publicity is getting that show back up a little bit. They're fighting kind of strong. That's all for this week. Have a great week at the theater.
I was so smiley the whole time.